The radio, which is a national broadcasting company for the state, and I'm going to be interviewed on Radio National on Bush Telegraph, which is a really good show, but it's in relation to me performing at millions and millions and millions of agricultural shows. It'll be good. So heading on in. Again? It's the human hand. How many fingers? Count the fingers.
Oh! 2, 3, 4, 5. No!
I love my life and I love being Roy Maloy. Another place that's very popular I'm not allowed to name on ABC. So this is a picture I'm taking now of Michael holding the six-fingered hand. Now that's actually not uncommon. There are a lot of people around the world with six fingers.
But not in a cigar box in my studio.
And we used to leave it closed for people to do exactly what you did.
Which I did, I freaked.
That's right. So we had Kangaroo Boy, we had Boy Without a Head, a lot of the old, you know, in a tent. Look, people would line up for days to see this stuff at $2.50 a head. And, you know, that was a lot of very hard work. But, so, you know, now that I can do 10 shows in a day, I don't...
Well, that's, I mean, that's pretty passive. I mean, that's the way you come along, you see the freaky thing, and then...
there you go. We're in the studio about to go live, and I'll be playing this via audio footage rather than motion footage, but enjoy.
From their self-titled album, Major Chord, and a song called I'm Just As Troubled As You. 22 to 12 here on Bush Telegraph, and I have a feeling that song's title might be apt for my next guest. I'm not sure, do you enjoy going to country shows? I love country shows. There's some fantastic rural shows around the nation. But if you do enjoy going to those kind of shows, chances are you might have come across a performer who's become a bit of an institution on the circuit. His name's Roy Maloy. He's also known as the Prince of Australian Vaudeville.
I decided to assist a group, find a sponsor who will build the stilts. There's a charity in South Australia, and in November they've got an event, and they want me to break the world record.
Which is
60 feet. So 60 feet is about four stories. I think it's about four. About four stories in a normal building. It's kind of different. When I broke the national record, it was 15 feet, but they were single beams. I just went to Bunnings. I bought the longest bits of wood I could find. Literally, Diggy Longlegs and Daddy Longlegs used to be those blokes in the Moomba parades who were always... They'd held the record as best we could tell at 12 feet. Mark St. Leon is a very famous circus historian, a good friend of mine, an amazing person too, and he kind of said, look, I think it's 12 foot. So we went for 15, and they bow. When you put your weight on them, they bow. So when it's at 60 feet, they've got to be made of scaffold that doesn't bow, and you're harnessed in, you've got cherry pickers.
And do you have to walk on them to qualify for the record?
Yeah, the company in England, who are Guinness Book of World Records' main competitor, they've said, look, if you can illustrate an ability to travel, so in other words, you're controlling the walk, we'll pay it for you. We're also going to, on the same day, have as many people file under the stilts as we can, which is called human bridging. Just to give you an update, for those of you who have just joined us, Michael just lost sight in his left eye from trying to blow up what we call a tying balloon.
Yes, while you were talking, I thought I'd blow up a balloon.
I blow up anything up to 300 of them a day. so that they are extraordinarily difficult to blow up. It takes the muscles below your diaphragm. If you play musicians,
I have
tend
nothing
to be able
below
to
my diaphragm.
So what he's trying to do right now is either give himself a hernia or pop something in his head. But they, I'll give you the example there.
Yeah, you've got
angle that.
And while you're doing that, I'll examine some other things you brought in.
Well, now that's blown up, so that it takes a second.
You could have actually done it a little slower.
it's just about the strength in the back of your cheeks, the strength of the back of your tongue and your diaphragm.
Yeah. Roy, it sounds like a marvellous thing that you do.
Thank you so much for having me.
I think you've achieved... obviously what you wanted to do when you threw yourself off that porch at the age of two and then scarred yourself at three, and you're doing it as a grown-up, so congratulations.
Well, anybody that wants to send me an email, do so at www.roymaloy.com, and thanks for having me.
Lovely to have you with us.
Pleasure.
Roy Maloy, everybody.
Thank
you. He's an entertainer. We'll be on the show circuit through regional and rural.